It's Tuesday, so it must be Kscope 2018 here at Walt Disney World in Orlando, Florida. I'm Bob Rubart with the Oracle Developer Community, and my guest for this segment is Scott Spendolini. Scott, how you doing?
I'm not too bad. Yourself?
Not bad, not bad.
Good,
you
good.
Know, it's day two, so my feet don't hurt too bad.
You need good shoes for these conferences,
yeah,
and you need to
support.
Make sure to sit down every so often.
It's all about the arch support.
It is.
So tell me about the sessions you're presenting here.
I already did one, so I'm halfway done already. The first one was called Hacking Oracle Apex, and the second one is going to be the last session of the conference on Wednesday, and that one is called Securing RESTful Web Services.
So let's talk about the first one.
Okay.
Hacking Oracle Apex. What's the focus of that other than the obvious?
Well, the focus is to not hack Apex, right? So what I do is show different techniques that people who would try to break into your system would use, right? So
yeah.
One of the tools I use is something called SQL Map. It's an open source utility that you could point at any web application system, and it'll try to find a SQL injection hole, exploit it, and then I show once I'm in, I could pretty much, you know, take anything I want. So the list of Apex users, the list of Apex workspaces, I could even query the Apex metadata dictionary and find out the SQL that Apex uses to generate the reports that I'm running. So it's pretty scary, and really, I've done the security presentation thing for a while now. What we've always done in the past, or what I've always done in the past, is just demonstrated, hey, this is a risk, you should fix it, but never really show the real damage that could be done.
Okay.
So this year I decided I really need to show what the risk is and how damaging it could be. So I took it up a notch, so to speak, and really just plowed right in there and started pulling out customer data and data dictionary data. I mean, it's really eye-opening. The good news is, of course, I also show how to fix it, right? How to prevent that from happening. And it's really easy. It's not a lot of work. It's just the example I use is, like, think back to your 10-year-ago code. I know mine isn't as good as it is today, and you might have made these mistakes 10 years ago. And 10 years ago, we weren't thinking like this with security. So that app that's been running great for 10 years, that the data's only grown, might have these vulnerabilities in it. So it's worth taking a second look, making sure that all your stuff is secure.
Okay, and then let's open the hood on Secure RESTful Services. And before you do that, I got to say, you have the most concise session titles, I think, in the whole conference. There's, you know,
less is more.
Three words each and for two sessions, where I'm like, look at some of these others here. There's
I'm lazy and I don't want to type a lot, so I just come up with very specific yet succinct titles.
So what goes on in Secure RESTful Services in that session?
So Secure RESTful Services is a little bit of a blend of ORDS and Apex. One of the most powerful things about ORDS is you could literally create a web service that exposes your Oracle database data in about a minute or two, maybe even less. One of the worst things about ORDS is you could create a web service that exposes your Oracle data in about a minute or less. It's eye-opening again that people are doing these things and not realizing that endpoint, that URI that you just created, is on the public internet, and that's your customer data. So I talk a lot about how we could do that better and how you could use the built-in capabilities of ORDS to lock that down. Now, it's just a little obtuse, and I think this industry kind of, I don't know, it's hard to predict like what they're going to call different terminology as they create these new technologies. So if you look at OAuth, which is kind of this open way to do distributed authentication, client ID and client secret, like, why not call it username and password? So a lot of people see those terms and they're immediately put off. And it sounds silly, but I was like terrified when I saw that.
Yeah.
What's a client ID? What's a client secret? Should I tell anybody the secret? Can I share the secret with the client? Is it truly secret? But once you distill that and once you understand, just call it username and password and you're fine, it's a lot easier to understand the steps to integrate ORDS to make it secure. So I use an Apex app as an example and basically say, here's select star from EMP. Everybody can see it. Here's a second web service, select star from EMP, where depno equals 10, and I lock that down with a client. So in order to see that data, you call an Apex API, which is built right in, and you could see that data set come back immediately. Now at 18.1, which of course got released like a week before all our presentations were due, it's even easier. You literally just point to that endpoint, and 18.1 takes care of mapping the client credentials and all that. So I guess I have time. I got a whole day and a half. I could probably redo the whole demo and do it on 18.1, but then that takes away some of my content. So maybe I'll leave it be and just let people see how easy 18.1 is to use on their own.
There you go. There you go. Okay, so you've described two sessions that you're presenting, and this is this gives us an idea of the information that you want to impart to the people who are attending this thing. What do you hope to learn at this conference? What sessions are you attending, and what do you want to take home?
It's always fun to go to sessions here. I don't get a lot of chance. This year, new job, new booth, been running around, customer meetings, Oracle ACE director meetings, and things like that. I did sneak into one this morning, Top 10 Things to Secure Your Apex Application by Simon Hunt. It was really cool because one of the things that he advocated would have helped someone solve one of the problems I illustrated yesterday. And he did come up to me after my session and say, thank you for not mentioning that. But I learned a couple things about, you know, how I could use different techniques, you know, outside of the Oracle database to help secure things. A couple that I wanted to see, I know I wanted to see Vincent's Progressive Web App. I missed that one. The good news is all the sessions or most of the sessions are recorded. So once you get back and the flurry of Kscope settles a little bit and you hit that summer season where there's not a lot of conferences, you could fire up on the Kscope site and watch those that you missed.
Yeah, because you can't be in three places at one time.
I hate to say it, but Kscope, you've got to decide which sessions you miss, right? There's four concurrent Apex, four or five concurrent database. You only get to go to one.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
It's a shame in a way, but luckily now everything's recorded. You know, you can go to those sessions later.
Yeah, true. It's a very content-rich event. Mm-hmm. Well, thank you for taking time out of your session schedule to come by and talk to me. And why don't you give the new company a plug?
Sure. Yeah. So I'm working for a company called Viscosity now. They're based out of Dallas. I will be moving to Austin within a month and a half. So that's excitingly terrifying is a good way to put it.
Great food, great music.
We love music. I'm really looking forward to the music. Really looking forward to that. I guess it's warm there. So
I hear.
Yeah, it gets a little hot in the summers. But that's my kids wear shorts all the time, even when it's 30 degrees. So I think that's going to be a little bit of a benefit to them.
You'll be able to attend South By without having to take a plane.
Right. Or a fleet of electric vehicles or something like that. We're already getting tickets to Austin City Limits.
Nice.
I mean, the lineup is huge. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'm going to run an Apex team of about 12 developers. So I went from 1 to 12 almost overnight. And we're going to do some pretty neat stuff. We've got some new products we're working on, some new services and things like that. So keep your eyes peeled for that. Stay tuned.
Well, sounds exciting and good luck. Thank you for watching. If you want more information about developer-oriented stuff, you should visit developer.oracle.com, where you'll find a bunch of articles and let's see, podcasts and videos and you name it, covering all sorts of technical topics. For the Oracle developer community, I'm Bob Rubart. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned.